So calls and puts when it comes to options markets. First of all, let's think about calls. Calls, when we're buying them, give us the right but not the obligation to purchase something in the future. Puts, on the other hand, give us the right but not the obligation to sell something in the future. Quite often we get asked whether you should be purchasing a call or a put in the marketplace. It all depends on what you think the stock price will do. If you think the stock price is going up, think about using a call option. If you think about the stock price maybe falling, use a put option. Another quick analogy to help you in understanding that, whenever I'm calling someone, I'm always calling someone up, putting the phone up to my ear. Think about markets going up when we purchase call options. When we're thinking about put options, on the other hand, I know in the morning I have a cup of tea or a cup of coffee, I always put that mug down on the table. So with put options, we want the markets to go down when we purchase those put options. Once you've purchased an option, there's a number of decisions that you have to make after that purchase. When it comes to call options, you can obviously sell those call options to the market, just like the way you sell shares. And you would do that if the market rallied in your favor and the stock price went up. Put options, on the other hand, you would want the market to fall. You could sell that option for a profit if the underlying security or stock price actually fell in value. If, however, you hold those calls and puts all the way through till expiry, then you have a choice to make. If the market's moved in your favour, you exercise your right to either buy if it's a call or sell if it's a put. Or if the market has moved against you, you let those options expire, because when we buy options, we have rights and not obligations.